Today, we have the pleasure to welcome Thierry Legrand, presenting the third session of this series of podcasts. This third session is on the layout of the dedicated railways, interoperability, annexet, and the methodology to be followed. But first, let me introduce our speaker of the day. After 12 years in the shipping business, Thierry Legrand joined SEN as a program manager in May 1994. He facilitated the development of a broad range of European standards in the field of transport and packaging. Amongst others, the programs related to the support of the Recreational Craft Directive, Cableways Installations Directive, and Railways Interoperability Directive. Today, he is the Account Manager Mobility in the Standardization and Digital Solutions Department of the SEN Senelec Management Center, where he coaches a small team of projects managers.
Okay, thank you, Marc-Antoine, for the introduction. Hello, everybody. So the purpose of this podcast, it will be to cover, you know, the new Annex AZZ template for railway interoperability, which has been approved by both SEN and Senelec BT in September this year, 2020. It will also describe, through an example, the methodology to be followed when drafting an Annex ZAZZ. There are a lot of documentation that I will present at the end of the podcast, but the elements to be connecting standard with a legislation are always contained in the European Forward and in the Annex ZA for SEN or ZZ for Senelec. Speak first about European Forward, and in fact, it's very easy because there is not much change in this European Forward. The European Forward is composed on a generic text, which is usually edited and checked and fine-tuned by the CMC editor. There are in this area only two technical committees developing standard, so it's quite easy to adjust the content of the forward. The Annex ZA or ZZ. The text introducing the Annex ZA is quite standard. The only elements which are different is the fact that it introduced two tables related to TSIs. So you see in yellow on the right of the slide, an example where there is an Annex ZA with a TSI on freight wagon and a TSI on locomotive and passenger rolling stock. Today, in absence of a standardization request, a new standardization request in order to support the Directive 2016-797, we will still refer to Mandate M4A3. As I mentioned, the Annex Z may contain one or several TSI tables. In order to populate the content of the Annex ZA, we have prepared a little guide, which is in the BOS of SEN and Senelec. And to prepare this annex, you need to take elements from this little table. The title of the table must always focus on the current applicable legislation. So that's why this table will be regularly updated. So first, for you, you need to identify what is the TSI you are addressing. In the example of the podcast, I took the freight wagon TSI. So I go in the table and I find in the table the correct wording of the TSI rolling stock. And this I will put on the top of the table. But I will continue to use this table, you will see later. Now that I have finished to fill in the title, I need also to add a specific note. Why do we have this note? It is because, as you know, in the railway interoperability, there are elements which are mandatory. And the elements of the standard which are mandatory, it's not necessary to repeat those in the annex ZA or ZZ. And that's why we need to indicate to the reader where those mandatory elements are. For the experts, it's quite easy. Based on the title of the TSI they choose, they can find the appendix they need to refer in the note. Here we are in the freight wagon, so we will refer to appendix D. There is then a third element that I will take from the table, and this will appear at the bottom below the detailed table, is the element which is contained, which give in fact additional information on the evolution of the TSI, and this is contained in front of the entry, is contained in the third column of the table. One of the guides which is contained in the SEN or SENELEC boss. So simply recopy and put at the bottom of the table the text which is contained here in this third column. You may, of course, develop tables for one, two, or three TSI, and each time you will need to take elements from this table. But there will be always a standard warning which will appear only once at the very bottom of the annex ZA or ZZ, and this is appearing here in light blue. Simply recopy once this warning. Now, we need to enter and populate the table itself. There is a big change in comparison to the past that you do not need anymore to worry about what are the essential requirements of the directive which need to be supported. Because in fact, they are always appearing in section 3 of each of the TSI. I say each of the TSI, it's not totally correct because for the moment, there is no section 3 in the control command TSI. But for all the other TSI, you simply, you do not need to mention all the essential requirements which are possibly impacting your table ZA, ZZ. It is listed, and you simply need to add this sentence in the first column. There may be cases where you need to connect directly a clause of the standard or several clauses of the standard to an essential requirement of the directive. This is very exceptional. And if you need to do this, of course, through your HRS consultant, you need to consult the commission and ERA, which will indicate if yes or not, you could do that. But it's good to know that this possibility exists as well. As I said already, you may have several tables supporting several TSI, but always one separate table per TSI. No, you are now populating the second column, and there you will indicate all the targeted clause that your standard may support. When you draw this column 2 and when you choose the clause, you can only indicate the clause of the TSI that are really effectively supported by a clause of the standard. And those clause of the TSI need to be supported by elements able to give presumption of conformity to the TSI, to the directive. So you will add for each clause of the TSI, you will make it in a separated line. Why it is important, this will be explained in the next slide, because the third column needs to match the clause of the standard with the specific TSI requirement. It is therefore excluded to do what was done often in the past, to simply mention the whole standard apply. This is not possible anymore. So as I said already, only indicate the clause of the standard for which the content gathers all the following points. It's a requirement. It cannot be a description. It is correct and precise and coherent. And it may be linked to one or several TSI requirements, which appear in the second column. And this really needs to give an added value. It needs to allow to fulfill presumption of conformity. It needs to really explain that all the obligation expressed in the TSI is achieved. Finally, there is, as usual, a column 4. But this is more for clarification. There was in the past a lot of text mentioned in this column. We have the tendency to ask to avoid putting too much information in this column, which can sometimes lead to confusion. Now, in this second part, I will explain the methodology how to design an annex ZA or ZZ. In this case, it is an annex ZA. It was one of the first attempts to implement this new annex ZA ZZ. So first, you need to forget the old layout. This is not possible, certainly, with a clause like this, the whole standard apply, and with the TSI requirements, which are not separated by line. And obviously, you do not need to list all the requirements of the directive. So what we did here, we had an initial annex ZA with two TSI. Was the lock and pass TSI and also the safety in railway tunnel TSI. But when we had a look more in depth in the safety in railway tunnel TSI, we realized that it was referring back to TSI requirements contained in the lock and pass TSI. And so we decided to simplify and to have only one reference to one table, the TSI lock and pass. Now, the second question that you always need to ask yourself is this standard, does this standard contain mandatory elements? Are there elements referred, are there clause standard referred directly in the TSI, in this case, lock and pass. If it's not the case, second question that you need to ask is it really a candidate for harmonized standard in the sense of referencing in the OJU. Present case, of course, is yes, it is an harmonized standard because there are requirements in the TSI which need to be supported by this standard, which is a kind of subsystem standard describing emergency system, emergency call. So what was the next step was to draft a kind of inventory, an exhaustive inventory of all the clause and subclause of the TSI, which were, look and pass TSI, of course, which were relevant for the standard. And then we, the working group, start to match each of the subclause with the clause of the standard. But you may imagine that if we make a granularity like this, it's a little bit heavy and it will lead to a very detailed annex Z. And so then we need to reconcile and we agree that we will only regroup all the clause of the standard vis-à-vis the core TSI clause, not the subclause of the TSI. And therefore, by converging from this list, we will regroup all the clause necessary and we get what we will include in the annex ZE. ZZ in the case of a Senelec standard. There is much more detail, of course, of the analysis done by for this standard. You may find this in the relevant material that I will explain you where to find later, and you will get the full Excel list for this standard. And so you can get really the full example that you can examine in detail. But based on the element you collect, you will be able to create your annex ZA. So from the Excel sheet I show you, we will take all those elements, which I'm now showing with the arrow. But of course, before doing this, you need to build the layout of your annex ZA lock and pass. And so you will go back to the famous table I was mentioning before. As it is the lock and pass TSI, you will find the title here. You will then add the note, but as it is the lock and pass TSI, looking in the table, you will see that the requirements are in an appendix G. And so just change G, put G next to appendix. And then in the third column of the table, you will find this little additional a legislative element that you simply recopy there. And don't forget the classical warning one, warning two. So the job is done, you have your table. And I only have now to tell you where to find the material. As I mentioned already, you can find those in SENBOS and in Senelec BOS. It's a very similar annex Z, A or ZZ. And all the materials, guidelines, podcast will be made available in the classical link that you can find on the Senelec website. Thank you for following this presentation. And